Standing at this point on the subway roundabout, you see the contemporary crested towers, the Kampala Serena Hotel, previously known as the Nile Hotel, the Parliament of Uganda, the Uganda Broadcasting Council, and of course the National Theatre.
At the Nile Hotel, that was the only place where tourists, the few tourists that were coming to Uganda, that's where they were staying. That's the place where Ugandans who had been in exile and were returning with a bit of a cultural hangover would bring their families. So from Christmas of 1988 up to Easter of 2003, every Sunday we did a free show at Nile Hotel.
The original plan for Kampala City was made by Ernest May, who concentrated cultural and entertainment activity places closer to the city center, but also in consideration of the opportunity for various classes of people to interact. The National Theater and the Uganda Museum are perfect examples of what he had in mind. But the location of National Theater, Uganda Broadcasting Corporation, and the Kampala Serena Hotel has over the years been seen as the best planned part of the city. The National Theatre is an example of the first public-private partnership that succeeded many years before this policy came into place.
So if you look, for example, at politics, you'll find Honorable George Nyombi Tembo, you'll find Honorable Mike Sebalu. These were in Indere. If you go to the performing arts, you'll find people like Okello Sam, you'll find people like Gordon Sezoba, you'll find people like Kadu, and many others, people in very, very high levels of government, people in high levels of business, they all have come through here.
Over the years, National Theatre was the place to be, even for students who came from upcountry to perform. They expected to rub shoulders with politicians and prominent people. Successive regimes have found the relaxing environment around the subway more comforting, even for visiting delegates. To ensure their safety, security and privacy, the then leaders crisscrossed from one of these places to another, passing through the subway. Recently, there was debate that the National Theatre would be demolished to pave way for a shopping mall. Artists were up in arms. It took the practical assurance of the Minister of Gender, Labour and Social Development through refurbishment that National Theatre is here to stay.
I really feel bad about is the way we erase history. If I had my way, I would not have demolished the old state house. I would have built a new one and kept this as a museum, because the whole history of Uganda was written in that house. So if we erase the National Theatre, we are erasing a piece of history. And I think that, I don't know whether it's because we have gone through turmoil in our history, we always want to forget the past, and as a result we also clear whatever was there. I would design, if we are to redo, because development is a must, I would redesign the around the existing building as a piece of history.
In recent years, the subway became a popular eating place for public servants working in the surrounding places, until the Kampala Capital City Authority repossessed it and allowed for the establishment of a vocational center for girls, one of the projects that President Museveni has supported to skill the youth. Lubega Emmanuel, reporting for Urban Television.